Welcome back. You're still watching Insight. According to a recent survey, global investors are most worried about geopolitics over inflation and other economic threats. As markets head into the new year, two wars are raging, one in Europe, the other one in the Middle East, and both are showing no signs of ending. Let's get a sense of what capital markets may look like in 2024. We're still joined by BPI lead economist June Neri and CUL Investment Management President Marvin Fausto. Let's now talk about, you know, concerns for 2024. And one of the major concerns that investors are highlighting is geopolitics. So June, as an economist, I mean, is this something that you are worried about?
Yeah, well, definitely, because we had Russia-Ukraine last year and Middle East this year. We're hoping it's not going to spread any further than that, especially in the Middle East. I hope it's just contained among the two parties involved, because for a while, people were scared, and that's the reason why oil prices started hitting $90 per barrel earlier this year. They were afraid that it could spread to the other Arab economies. You know? So while this seems to be far-fetched at this point, a little bit of a low probability event, we can't really rule out the spread of the tensions farther into the other Arab economies. So that could be a big disappointment for 2024. No? Not including, of course, the Asian region and the tensions that are happening in this part of the world. So it's both are still low probability events, April. No?
Yeah, geopolitics is like your black swan. It's something you cannot really anticipate or something you cannot really predict. It will just hit you behind China, Taiwan, and all of these other things that's happening in the world. We cannot really. What's important for us, more particularly for investors, is to keep your powder dry. I mean, you reserve some for any unexpected event that can allow you to participate in prices that that can be lower because of this. No, so that's very important for us to have a balanced portfolio, meaning a portfolio that's opportunistic in this kind of a market.
So how should investors position their portfolios for 2024?
Yeah, for 2024, it's really going to be like we just launched a fund this October, and that fund is really geared towards this kind of volatile market, opportunistic kind of a fund, meaning it's an equity fund, but it's a actively managed. So we call it COL Strategic Growth Fund. And that is really geared towards now fixed income, because fixed income is really the one we are more favorable now because of high interest rates. And then when interest rates go down, the bond market will go up. It will benefit the fund. And then look at the income of that fund, the income of that bond to be positioned in equities. And also now, when there's an opportunity for equities over the short term, because of the pause in the Fed, we shift to the equities. So it's going to be very active. It's going to be a very active portfolio where opportunity lies. So immediately there's going to be bond exposure, an opportunistic trading tactical allocation for equities. So that's what we're going to do in the fund we just launched. Yes.
Okay. So in other words, if I were to summarize what both of you said, 2024 will be a cautiously optimistic year for the economy, the Philippine economy, like I would say even the US, a soft landing. And for bonds, it's going to be good. For equities, it's going to be a volatile market, but in general, still positive. Okay, so with that, thank you very much for your thoughts, June and Marvin. I do hope that, we'll see more positive outcomes in 2024, both for the economy and, bonds and equity markets as well. Thank you so much for your thoughts. Before we wrap up the show, we leave you with a quote from author and public speaker John Naisbitt. Countries don't create economies. It is entrepreneurs and companies that create and revitalize economies. The role of the governments, should be to create a nourishing environment for entrepreneurs and companies to flourish, not to get in the way of economic development.